Sud Squad, Joanna here, the soap gal. Today I have heard you. How do I use Soap Maker 3? How do I create a formula using a 50-50 lye solution? Well, guess what? Sit down, grab your computer, load up Soap Maker 3, and I'm going to show you how to get started. I have my Soap Maker 3 loaded on my computer right here. And what is Soap Maker 3? Well, Soap Maker 3 is the software that I use when I formulate my soap. It is amazing. Where can you get Soap Maker 3? Well, there's so many places where you can purchase Soap Maker 3. You can purchase it from soapequipment.com and just talk to Robbie, or you could talk to Norm from Arizona Soap Supply, or I think there's Nova Soaps in California that has it. Just Google Soap Maker 3 and there's so many places where you can go and purchase a download. It's kind of the down part of Soap Maker 3 is right now it only works on Windows systems. I know all of you Mac users, you're absolutely like, why can't I use that software? Well, it's only made right now for Windows, but you know what? A computer, it's like a couple $100, and just focus it for just Soap Maker 3, just your soap making, and I'm sure it's a business expense. It's worth every penny. I absolutely love the software. I wouldn't be where I am today if it wasn't for Soap Maker 3. I am so blessed and I make so much soap, but if I didn't know how to use Soap Maker 3 for my formulation, I wouldn't be here today. So that's how important that this software is. So let's just dive right in. So when you get into your soap maker, you will see that there's your preferences, there's my recipes, my supplies, my products, and then comes graphs and conversions and stuff. We're just gonna do a very basic class today. So we're gonna go straight to my recipes, and there you will see all your different formulas that you have, but we're gonna go straight to new formula. And we're going to make sure that this is sodium soap. That means it is done with a sodium hydroxide, NaOH, or you can use potassium hydroxide, or you could do a combination soap, which would be a cream soap, or you can do a non-soap product. So like if you make candles, or if you do lip balms, or lotions, or creams, or you just wanna save your grandmother's recipe for spaghetti, I mean, it doesn't matter what it is. It could totally go into Soap Maker 3. So, but we're gonna be using a NaOH sodium hydroxide. So we're gonna click on that. Okay, now that we have that up, we're gonna close our window of our files and we're gonna move this folder over. And we are going to now pick out our oils. So I personally think it's not a good soap unless it has olive oil. So we're gonna look up olive oil. And we can use olive palmas or olive pure. We're just gonna go straight with just normal old, good old olive oil. We're not gonna make this a savor soap or pumice bar. So the next one we're gonna use is we're gonna use coconut. So we're gonna go down to coconut and then we're gonna use castor. I mean, if you want lather, you're gonna have some castor. So let's put our castor oil in and then we're gonna add in our shea butter. Okay, so now that we have all that, we're going to change this from pounds to ounces. So we're going to do that at the bottom of all of our soaps. So make sure that's good. Okay, shea butter. So for my olive oil, I'm going to do that at 50%. My coconut oil, I'm going to put that in at 30%. My castor oil, let's do that at 5%. And then down here, it shows you where your percentages are at or your ounces. So, and then our shea butter, I'm gonna put that in at 5% as well. So now we're at 100%, okay? So we are now going to go to our lye water. So this is where the 50-50 magic begins. And I just made up a recipe guys, I've not ever done that. That's not a formula. I'm just kind of making up as I go here. So right here shows you're at 6%. We're gonna say use pre-mixed lye. We're gonna click on that, okay? So we're going to do a 1-to-1 ratio. So we're gonna change that to a 1. So now we have our 50-50 solution, okay? Then we're gonna go to the lye water ratio, and we're gonna do that at 2 parts water to 1 part lye. So our water ratio is gonna be 2, and our lye is gonna be 1. So then that gives us a 19% water discount. Okay, so now that's done. So now when we go to make this soap, we know we're using our pre-made 50-50 solution, which you can purchase from Makesies. And then we're going to add in our additional liquid. So this liquid could be goat's milk, coconut cream, water, whatever you can think of. We know we're going to be using 12.6 ounces of our additional liquid because we already have 12.6 ounces of water to make the 50-50 solution in this formula. So then the next step of what we're going to do is we're going to pick out our essential oils. So we're gonna add our essential oils, and what scent do we want? I have eucalyptus. I think I'm gonna do my eucalyptus, and we're also gonna add another essential oil of spearmint. That's just such a nice combination. So we're gonna do spearmint. So we're going to change this also to ounces, and we're gonna change this over to ounces. And I definitely want to have more of the eucalyptus. So we're gonna add, we're gonna do 3 ounces. Okay, this is a smaller batch. So 1.5 ounces of eucalyptus, and we're gonna do 2 ounces of spearmint. So it's gonna be really spearminty and with some eucalyptus. All right. And then you can add in your packaging, but this is what's so cool. It has this fatty acid. So now we can see here, okay, our hardness of this bar is a 6. The fluffy lather is a 5.1. The stable lather is a 5.7. And the moisturizing, ooh, this is a very moisturizing bar. Ooh, it is 6.4 ounces. And then it goes into all of your different fats and saturated and unsaturated fats. So it shows you their whole process, and then you have your other options. It's like, wow, what do you want the ingredients to be shown as? And then your portion size, and it also shows you like your waste and how much it is and what's your batch size. And then from there, you can put in your labor rate. Okay, how many hours is it going to take you to make this bar of soap, and what's your hourly rate? Very important step. And then you can do notes, okay? So, but we're going to resize this. We're gonna save this. Okay, yes, we're gonna save it. We're going to call this soap gel test, okay? Just so you guys know. And I'm gonna just put it in a folder so we can save it. All right, so now we're gonna go back to resize. All right, this is so cool. So down here, you can fit a mold, okay? It's a new mold. Here is your size of your mold. So we're gonna say that the length of this mold is 10 inches. The width of this mold is 3 inches, and the height of this mold is 3 inches, okay? And then you can name this test mold, and then save it, okay? So now you can add how much waste allowance in your batch. I never allow 10% waste. I typically do like 3% waste, but on this one, just so you can see the mold size, I'm gonna put 0, and then you push okay. And now it shows you that this mold that I just made up is the batter size that you're gonna need is gonna be 3 pounds, 3.6 ounces. And then it breaks down like, okay, you're gonna be needing 19.6 ounces of coconut and 19.6 ounces of olive oil, 11.8 ounces of coconut, 2 ounces of castor, and 2 ounces of shea butter. And then it shows the 50-50 lye solution and then your additional liquid. So we'll be needing, it's 9.9, I'd round that up to 10. So 10 ounces of your 50-50 solution, which we have a video that you guys can watch on how we make that 50-50 lye solution, or you can purchase it. And then 5 more ounces of whatever you want. And then it could also break it down. If you go over here, it shows you the cost of all the raw materials. And these are not current prices. So I don't want you guys to think I can do a batch of soap for $4.33. I could have in 2019, not today. So, but that's just basically a run through of how I use Soapmaker 3. Then you can also keep track of all your products and your lot codes. If you go to make this, it can show you a graph. So you can come here and click on graph, and it shows you the graph of like what your soap is and what's like, you know, the benchmark versus the soap gal versus the resize batch, you know, where you're at on everything. So the graphs are really cool. And then you can go to the full screen where you can see everything at one time. And then you can just go to make, where if you go to make, then you're able to put in your lot codes and you can keep track of your batch sheets. So there's so much that you can do with Soapmaker 3. And if you have any more questions, please let me know. Real quick, I am going to go back to showing you how to do it with the lye water if we didn't do it as a 50-50 solution. So if we didn't do it as a 50-50 solution, then it would just tell you that you need 12.6 ounces of sodium hydroxide beads and 1 pound, 9.2 ounces of water. But as soon as I click on this little thing is make it into a lye solution, it breaks it up. So right there, guys, no 50-50 solution, 50-50 solution. No 50-50 solution, 50-50 solution. So I want you guys to really, I think the software is like $100. It is such an amazing investment for yourself when it comes to your soap formalization. It's what keeps your prices and keeps your costs and for you to truly know what you're doing. And you're just able to have that second step of confidence of, oh, this formula works. No, this formula don't work. It helps so much. And it's like you have all these base oils. I mean, so many different base oils. Real quick, let me go into supplies and just kind of show you like all the base oils. Look at all these different oils that they have. And it has the values and the sap values and just everything you need, that anything you can imagine, it's in here. If not, you could put it in here. So I hope this quick tutorial will help you to understand how to formulate a bar of soap. And if you have any questions, just leave a comment below. And remember, lather, rinse, profit, repeat.